Hello, everyone. Thank you for being here. And as our host presented, I'm going to talk to you about the DNA data storage. But beyond that, I want to give you a little bit of introduction about the general topic, which is technological footprint. So you hear a lot recently about ecological footprint, about carbon footprint, about climate change, but that's not going to be what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about technology. And it turns out that around 10% of the global waste now goes under the technology field. So even though technology has to improve our lives, make our lives better, but actually it produces so much pollution that it kind of gives a lot of harm as well. And most of that harm goes under data storage. So what is data storage? Data storage is the way we store the information that we have. A lot of you have a lot of pictures on Instagram. You have text messages in your messenger apps. I have this presentation. The global companies have a lot of data about their employees. Government has a lot of data. All that data has to be stored somehow. And historically, we've been using different methods to store that data. We've been using coming from the tapes up to the modern hard drives. So all the ways of data storage have improved continuously. And they provide us with the ability to store the enormous amount of data that we have. And it is estimated that currently in the world, there are around 18 zettabytes of data. And until the year 2025, it's going to rise to 175. So for you to imagine the size of this data, if you wanted to download 175 zettabytes into your computers using the current internet connection, it would take up to 1.8 billion years. So this is really great amount of data that we are going to have in the upcoming 5 years. And what do we do, like generally, if you want to store something, if you are on a vacation, if you have a lot of pictures, a lot of videos, movies, you go and buy a hard drive. So the average hard drive that we have right now is around 1 to 2 terabytes. And this is going to give you the capacity to store a couple of movies, a lot of pictures, but it's going to run out at some point. And you're going to need to buy another one. So you buy just another hard drive. What if it's a big company like Google or Microsoft and they want to store a lot of data? They just built what we call now data farms. And the data farms are like, for you to imagine what that is, it's like a big town full of hard drives. To sustain all that, we need a lot of energy. To give you some numbers about the energy and about the pollution that one hard drive produces, I'm going to talk about silicon chips right now. And the silicon chips are what is inside every hard drive. Every hard drive is composed of different silicon chips. And to make one silicon chip that is able to store 32 megabytes of data, we need a lot of pollution. We need around 1,600 grams of fossil fuel. We need a lot of electricity. A lot of harmful chemicals are being produced in that process. And one bad statistic is that the people who work in the manufacturing of the silicon chips, 30% of those people get different sicknesses of lungs related to their profession. So this is really bad. And we have to think about a way to reduce all this harm concerned with the data storage. And it turns out that nature has this solution way before we started to think about data, and it is the DNA. The DNA, as all of you know, is a molecule that is inside of us, that is there in the nature, and the nature uses this molecule as a way to store the data that it has. Our DNA has information about us, about our parents, about our grandparents, about our eye color, our height. All of the information that is stored in our DNA talks about us. So if nature chose DNA to be the molecule that it is going to store the information inside, why not we use DNA as well? And this is what two people in New York back in 1988 thought, and they tried to make artificial synthetic DNA, which was going to store the information that they wanted. So just to give you a bit background, DNA is composed out of four letters, A, T, C, and G. And it's basically a chain of those letters, an unlimited number of letters which stand for a specific code. And those two people in New York, they took general alphabet letters and they decided to say that, for example, the sequence of A, G, and G is going to stand for the letter A, and so on. Took this alphabet that they made it into an artificial DNA, put it into a letter, and sent the letter to another lab. The people in that lab were able to read the message by reading from the DNA. And this was the first example of how people did DNA data storage. Later on in the years to come, people tried to store more data in the DNA. In the year 2012, two people from Britain took entire Shakespeare poetry collection, two movies and a couple of pictures, and they made another artificial DNA and stored the data inside that DNA. And what they found out is that DNA was able to store enormous amount of data. It is what they called ultra compact. And it is really compact. 1 gram of DNA can store more data than there has ever been on the planet at any time of the history. So it is really compact and it can store a lot of data inside. Another advantage of DNA is that DNA is very stable. As far as I can see right now from the audience, maybe some of you have heard about the floppy disks. So they were a way that we used to store data before, like 20 years ago. Our parents used floppy disks a lot. Even I didn't have much chance to see floppy disks. But the problem with those disks and other types of data was that if you right now want to retrieve an information from a floppy disk, it's going to take a while for you to do. Because floppy disks are not used and the information there is lost. So is the information in a lot of different types of media. So what I want to say is that the media of the data storage types are changing every time, and we're dealing with the problem of storing more data in different types of data storage media. But the DNA is stable, because as long as we are around, DNA is going to be around. DNA is going to be there, and we are going to be able to make DNA and read from the DNA. So it is another advantage. And the biggest advantage above all is that the DNA creates no pollution. We, right now, every one of you inside your bodies, you make DNA. Your cells make DNA every moment, and there is no pollution. There is no pollution in making DNA as much as there is in making silicon. So at any time of the history, the world should understand that switching from conventional data storage types to DNA data storage is going to solve a lot of problems. But it's not that great right now, because it has some problems. It is not that time efficient as, for example, flash drives. To store information inside DNA, you would need a couple of days. And to store 1 megabyte of information, right now you would need $2,500. So it's not that cheap, but it is improving. If you look back in the history, for example, in the year 1980, to store 1 megabyte of data in the hard drive that we have right now, you would need around $500,000. But now you need just 5 cents. So the money that we needed to store data in flash drives over the last 40 years has decreased 10 million times, and the DNA is doing the same. So what we imagine to do in the future is that every one of us is going to have a small device by their computers, and they're going to be able to make DNA the moment they want to store data, and when they want to read from DNA, they're just going to put the DNA inside that machine and read from that machine. And to do that, we need to work. We need a lot of research. We need a lot of time to switch from conventional data to DNA data. So what do we do now? In Armenia, I'm the project leader of 15 bright people in high school, and we're trying to implement this technology in Armenia. We're trying to apply this technique in different long-term data storage firms, trying to convince them to switch from the data farming technology into the DNA technology. And we hope to achieve that, and we hope to make a slight contribution to changing the world by switching from the data storage media. Thank you for your attention.